Good morning. I have been keeping in touch with you all through WhatsApp messages and circulars. I hope all of you are reading the same. Please spare some time from your busy schedule to read the WhatsApp messages and circulars. It gives you an idea regarding all the programs we have organized for your ward on the online platform. This year we have a different academic session, and I am here to familiarize you with the online teaching learning process and the assessment pattern we follow in SEC. Along with me, there are two other guest speakers. One is Dr. A. Srikumar, who is the chairman of Wellness Solutions. He will speak about how to maintain good physical and mental well-being in children. The second is Dr. Srikanth Pillai, who is a senior IT consultant. He will give you guidelines as to how to keep track of your child's activities online. Both these sessions will be extremely beneficial to you. I familiarize you with the online teaching learning system and assessment pattern we follow in SEC. We are following a blended approach as instructed by CBSE, wherein we have live lessons as well as podcasts or video tutorials. We have got license for the full version for G Suite for Education, and after the oral exams are over, we'll be sharing the G Suite ID and password of the children. So you will all have accounts in sec.ac.in domain. So once we let you know the G Suite ID and password, you can log in with the same and accept the invitations to the various classes. Once you accept the invitations to various classes, in your account you can see all the classrooms in which your ward is a part of. So once you open a classroom, you can go to the tab Classwork to see all the materials that are uploaded in this particular tab. So under Classwork, you can see the materials for this particular subject. So you have video, you may have video lessons, you may have PDF notes, you may have recorded lessons. All the materials are uploaded under Classwork. When you open those materials, you can view in detail. That is, you can see the video lessons here, you can see the notes here. You can click on any one of these to open and learn from this. So we are conducting the online lessons using Google Meet. So usually the teachers upload the materials related to the topic being taught during the online lessons in Google Classroom. So the student can learn from this material either on the same day, or if it is being uploaded later after the classes are over, you can learn it later also. So learn from this material and then be ready for the online lessons. So during the online lessons, you can clear doubts with your teachers. Now we have to follow certain modalities in online mode of teaching. So in online mode of teaching, unlike the traditional mode of teaching, there is a lot of involvement from the parents' side. The parents and teachers should have a good rapport, because you have to keep on, the parents will have to inquire with the teacher about the progress of their child, and then you have to ensure that the child is writing the notes correctly in neat handwriting, date is being put for each day's work. So here the teachers are not able to correct the notebooks, so it is your responsibility to see that the child is writing the notes correctly. And I am thankful to you for the wholehearted cooperation and support which you have rendering to the teachers and to the school. So you have the freedom to contact your ward's teacher at any time to clarify the doubts. So if you want to know how much your child has imbibed, you can contact the teacher and see how the progress of the child is happening. To make the online mode of teaching successful, the parents have to do the follow-up with the child. Daily you have to inquire with your child whether the online classes has happened smoothly, whether they had any interruptions, whether they could attend the class properly, whether they noted down the notes properly, did they finish learning the portions for that particular day, did the teacher ask you some questions. Please inquire it on a daily basis, because teachers are of the opinion that whenever they ask a question to the child is not responding back. So you have to ask daily, you have to find it out whether the teacher has asked some questions, whether they gave a proper answer for that. If you are there at home, just monitor the online classes in between. See whether the child is attending the class properly, are they giving the answers, and whenever they come online, ask the child to on the video mode. because teachers want to see what they are doing, whether they are listening to the classes properly, whether they are noting down the notes properly. So for all these, the video mode should be turned on. And the chat room, if some queries have been put across by the teacher, they can use the chat room to give the answers for that. The chat room should never be used by the children to chat among themselves. So chat room has to be used purely as a learning tool. You have to treat your online classroom just like the real classroom. Dress modestly, comb your hair, neat and keep it neat and tidy. And also the place where you sit should be free from all disturbances. The child should be able to concentrate fully on the class. Another important thing is you have to manage the screen time properly, because right now we are using the digital devices for learning. So use the digital devices only for that purpose. Don't use it for anything else like playing online games or browsing. Keep away the digital devices after your online lessons and learning is over. Now I would like to bring into your notice the 21st century skills. We are already familiar with all these skills, but the CBSE wants us to reiterate once again. So I am just bringing to your notice the various 21st century skills which are required by the student to lead a successful life. Those are, broadly we can classify the 21st century skills into learning skills, literacy skills and life skills. So under learning skills you have critical thinking, creativity, communication, collaboration. So all the projects and activities which we give to the children are taking care of these skills. Now under literacy skill you have information literacy, media literacy, technology literacy. This is of very important use now because we are using the technology in every area of our teaching learning now. Life skills includes flexibility, leadership, initiative, productivity and self-awareness. And each and every lesson has got activities catering to life skills. So the 21st century skills helps the student to think scientifically, mathematically and artistically and help them to face the real life challenges in this information technology driven world. And it helps to enhance their inherent talents. The teachers have asked me to point out few things to you. One is like online, during the online lessons, we find the children having snacks. So please don't do that. Let the children have their food before the online lessons. And when they sit for the online lessons, don't give them snacks. And also see to it that they are sitting in a place without disturbances. Because once the class starts, it should go continuously and they should be seated wherever they are. They should be attending to the classes eagerly. And the teacher usually tells them to complete some work and come for the next session. Parents kindly see to it that the children have read the portions, they have gone through the materials uploaded in the Google Classroom, they have completed their notes. So right now the teachers are not able to correct the notebooks. So parents, you have to see that the children are writing the notes by putting the dates in the margin. They are writing the notes neatly without spelling errors. And you have to check the maths assignments given by the teachers. Just check that the students have completed that. They are writing neatly to their notebook. Now this is how the assessment for classes 3 to 5 is. You have, for each term, you have 2 periodic tests. Each periodic test is out of 20 marks and the terminal exam is out of 40 marks. Second term also you have 2 periodic tests and the terminal exam which is out of 40 marks. So when you add up all these, it comes to 100 marks. Now the periodic test marks have been brought down to 10. It will be total of 40 marks, it will be brought down to 10 marks in each term. In each term, internal assessment marks will be given for art integrated project which has been newly added by CBSE. So 5 marks have been kept apart for this art integrated project which is a cross-discipline project. It is spanning across different subjects. For the notebook correction, there is another 5 marks. So we have for 3 to 5 online assessment happening from Monday. So this online assessment will happen on Google Meet and it is all objective type questions. The maximum marks allotted is 10 and the time allotted is 30 minutes. So the students will be admitted to Google Meet. After all the students are admitted, the teacher will share the link of the question paper in the chat room. The child can click on the link and write her, his or her details like the roll number, name, etc. And then she can select the correct answer against each question. Once she has completed all the questions and answers, she can click on submit button. So once you have submitted your answers, you can click on view score to view your score as well as to copy down the question and answers to a legal sized ruled answer paper. So in this legal sized ruled answer paper, the child has to write neatly his or her roll number, his or her name, then class, division, the name of the subject, then the question paper title, all those have to be neatly written onto the answer sheet. And this answer sheet has to be filed. There will also be an oral test for 10 marks for classes 3 to 5. So this oral test will be conducted by the subject teacher in their respective period. They will be admitting the children roll number wise and you will get instructions regarding this from the subject teachers. This is a grade allotment for classes 3 to 5. There will be changes to this. The CBSE will be informing about the changes by mid-July, and once we come to know about the changes, we will be issuing circulars regarding the same. Before we wind up, I would like to bring to your notice the four types of intelligence. I came across this one as a WhatsApp message in the State Bank of India Pensioners Association. One grandparent had forwarded this message, so I just wanted to share this with you. So four types of intelligence, we are all familiar with that, that is intelligence, IQ, emotional intelligence, social intelligence. The first three we are all familiar with, but the last one is a new paradigm, that is adversity quotient or adversity intelligence. So intelligence quotient or IQ is what helps the child to comprehend, to reproduce and to memorize things. And we give a lot of importance to that in the school. Now the next one is emotional quotient or EQ, which is actually the character building intelligence. So it helps the child to keep the time, be responsible, be honest, respect boundaries, be humble, genuine and considerate. The next one is the social quotient or the social intelligence, which determines the charisma of the child. So this is the measure of your ability to build a network of friends and maintain it over a long period of time. And the success of a person depends upon the emotional quotient and the social quotient. If you have more of emotional quotient and social quotient, you are a successful person because you are able to, you have a strong character is being built with the help of emotional quotient and you have a strong network of friends which is with the help of social quotient. Now the new paradigm is adversity quotient. So when you face a rough patch in your life, when you go through a difficult situation in your life, how do you bounce back? Whether you are able to come back with full mental stability, that is what adversity quotient determines. And this is what we require in the current scenario. The adversity quotient determines who will give up in face of troubles and may abandon their families. So adversity quotient, if it is high, you will come unscathed irrespective of what trouble you are facing. You will emerge fully successful out of any difficult situation, or you will actually turn that difficult situation to your advantage. And the advice to the parents is, expose the children to other areas of life other than academic. They should adore manual work, sports, art, develop their EQ, SQ and AQ. They should become multifaceted human beings able to do things independent of their parents. Do not prepare the road for the children, prepare the children for the road. Thank you.